Okay, so what we're going to start off with is a two-block high pillar. Then leave a gap, place a block, leave a gap, place a block, leave a gap, place a block, leave a gap, place two blocks. Then leave a gap, place a block, leave a gap, place two blocks. Gap, block, then two blocks. Gap, block, gap, two blocks. Gap, block, gap, two blocks. Like so. Then each of the gaps we're going to place in a right way around stair, pointing outwards towards the passers-by. Then on top of each of the blocks we're going to place a stair, once again facing us. Then a slab on top of each of the stairs. Then taking your slabs, you want to go 1, 2, 3 and just follow the pattern all the way around the fountain. Then on the longest corners, on the longest side, sorry, and the corners of them, you want to be placing a wall, a glowstone block, trapdoors around the block, a slab on top, then same on this one. With your slab on top. And then another one on here, because this will be your one of your longest edges. With a slab on top. And then you want to do this pattern 3 more times until you have a kind of square rectangle like the one here. So I'll quickly finish this off, you do the same, and I'll be right back to you. Okay, so once you've done the other sides, you'll end up with something looking a little like this. What you can also do is just add a slab on top of all of the sort of inner corner parts, just to bring them above the one which is on the outer and give it a bit of variety. What we can then do is go from one of the longest edges and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then do a 3-block line, then 1, 2, 1, 2, fill in, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like so. You then place another layer on top, and replace this front one with an upside down stair. You do that with all 4 of the sides, so you'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, obviously. Do what you did before and bring them all up by one as well. And then on the 4th row, you have a 5-block one. Then once you have all 4 of the sides in, you just fill in the center with the rest of the block. You can just do the top layer or you can do both layers. For this, I'm going to do both layers. So go around and finish off the other side parts. I'll do the same, and I'll be right back to you. Okay, so the next thing we want is to do the first layer of the line. So we want stair, stair, upside down stair, upside down stair, stair in the corner, stair in the corner, block, block behind the stair, and block behind the stair. Now for the next layer. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is bring up the upside down stairs by one block, the block by one block, upside down stair in the middle, upside down stair in the middle, and upside down stair in the middle. Then an upside down stair on the side, and then upside down stairs pointing inwards towards the center. Now we move on to the next layer. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then one here, and bring these up by one as well. You then want to place an upside down stair, then an upside down stair, which is cobblestone, and then a cobblestone slab on the front of that. Now we move on to the next layer. Next thing we want to do is start with by doing a 5-block layer and then a 3-block layer of stone, then 2 stairs on the sides, then 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2 of blocks, then a cobblestone block, an upside down cobblestone stair, and then two upside down stone brick stairs either side of the cobblestone block. Now we move on to the next layer. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is take stone bricks and do a 3x5 layer. Then slabs on top of the pillars by the sides, followed by an upside down stair, a right way around stair, and a right way around stair, either side of the upside down stair, and then an upside down stair on the sides of the 3x5 block. Now we move on to the next layer. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is place a whole layer of stone bricks once again. Then remove these two end ones, place in a right way around stair and a corner stair and right way around stair. Then an upside down cobblestone stair, a right way around cobblestone stair next to that. Same on the other side of the lion. Then a right way around stair, upside down stair. And then we can move on to the next layer. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is take cobblestone and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then a slab. Then a stair facing this way, and then a stair to make it a corner stair, but pointing like that instead. You then need to place a stair, right way around stair there, and there on top of the upside down stair. Cobblestone and cobblestone. Upside down stair. Upside down stair. Upside down stair and upside down stair to make upside down corner stairs. Then a slab on the block. And then you're done. And now we can move on to the next layer. For the next layer, you want to be having this as the mouth layer. So you have a block there. Then upside down stairs either side of it. Then a block. A stair. Make it a corner stair. Then a slab. A slab. A stair on the end, and then 1, 2, 3 cobblestone blocks, and then we can move on to the next layer. Okay, the last thing we want to do is place a stone brick on top of the stone brick we already have, place in 2 cobblestone, a stair, stairs on top of the corner stairs either side, then another stair to make the mouth, but it'll be a stone brick, then 1, 2 cobblestone slabs on top. And then once you've got that lion, you then want to make the same thing on the other three pedestals out of the same, and I'll be right back to you. Once we have the 4 lions in like so, what we can then do is start to make the floor look a bit nicer. To do this, we just remove the whole outer layer, if you've got a outer layer to use, of the fencing sort of area to fence off the fountain. We remove this layer, going all the way around. Like so. We do the same for where the foundation layer is, going all the way around. If you accidentally destroy any, remember to replace it. So we go all the way around the foundation until we have these sort of gaps in. We then fill all of these gaps with stone brick. I'll quickly go around and finish this off. You do the same, and I'll be right back to you. What we can then do, once we have all that in, is any gaps in between all of the stone, we just remove any grass or whatever we're using and just replace it with cobblestone. Now I'm going to do these for the rest of these gaps. I advise you do too, and I'll be right back to you. Okay, so once we have the flooring in, we can finally add the water to the fountain. So what you want to do is go into here and basically just place a bucket of water. Actually, before we do that, let's place in a 3x3 grid, and then place in a bucket of water to distribute the water evenly. So we do that all in these gaps. And then, as you can see, it pours down in the sides like so. We can then fill in all this water going around. So we have nice flat water, so there's no random fountains going on like so. So it's all nice and flat, I'm pretty sure. Yep, we're all good. Then on the top, what you can do is take your stone bricks and go 1, 2, 3, 1, 1 stone brick stairs to form corner stairs. And then you take a stone brick slab and go 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, like so. We can now add the water into the line mouths. Now, before we do this, what we want to do is go to slash, give, player, and then what we're going to type in is barrier. Now, if you're on survival, you don't have to do this, but if you're on creative, it's quite nice to split the water like so. And then we do this for each of the lion mouths. Like so, last one. And then we are done for this tutorial. So thanks guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Remember to leave a like, subscribe, and leave a comment if you haven't done so already. See you next time. Bye.